Hello, welcome to all of you. In my lecture today, I am going to discuss my third lecture on the control system. In my previous lecture, already I have discussed about the difference between feed forward and feed backward control system. And in, I have started feed forward backward control system, and in feed backward control system, I have discussed about the positive feedback control system and negative feedback control system. Today, I am going to discuss about the feedback control system and the reduction of block diagram. That's very important thing. How will we reduce the block diagram? If block diagram is given, how will we calculate the set point, or how will we calculate the closed loop response of the feedback-backward control system? Now, here our topic is transfer function of closed loop system. Transfer function of closed loop system. Understand the concept. So, what I have told you in my previous lecture, there are two types of problems that we will see as a question in our GATE examination. First is servo problem, and second is regulatory problem. So, I will be discussing that in later on. First, try to understand how we use to solve the closed loop system or block diagram. So, first, reduction of block diagram. This concept is very important. You all know, you all are aware about the transfer function, first order transfer function, second order transfer function, all these things, okay. So here I am going to discuss, understand one thing. If this is a transfer function is given, if z1 is given and z2 is given, if here this is x and this output is y, you have to reduce this block diagram. It's very simple block diagram, and you have to reduce this block diagram. Now, how will you reduce this? Try to understand. Here, just understand this is P. What I have understood, just try to understand. Here, I have assumed this is P. So, if you want to write P, that before P, G1 and S is there, that is in the series form. So, what you need to do is, you need to multiply P x into z. P is equal to what? Whatever the transfer function that is placed previous, that you need to multiply z1 x. Again, what you need to do if you want to calculate y, that is equal to what? Z2 into P. Z2 into P. Now, you have calculated the value of P, so just you can substitute the value of P here, and you will be getting y that is equal to z2 g1 x. Now, what you need to do, this is our output and this is our input, so transfer function will always be in the form of output upon input. So we have to mold this transfer function in the form of output by input. So y by x that is equals to g1 g2. I think you all have understood this, and it's very clear to all of you. Alright, what you need to do is this is our output. This is our output and this is our input. So in this form you have to control, you have to keep the format. Now this will be the transfer function of this process that I have made this block diagram here. The transfer function of this process will be like in this y by x, and that is equals to g1 g2. That is equals to g1 g2. I think you all have understood these things now. Okay. So this was the basic things now. Understand one thing. what you need to do. This was in the series form. Now, if this is written in this form, if this is given, this is G2, and they both are coming here at a particular point, and this is our Y and this is our X. Means here what you have to understand, try to understand, here when these two transfer function is placed in the parallel, this is the series form, this is the series form, this is the series form, and this is our parallel form. This is our parallel form. So in parallel form, what you need to do, in series form, what you need to do is you have to multiply the total process. Now in the parallel form, what you can understand is, if you want to write y is equal to g1 into x, so here you can say y is equal to g1x, y is equal to g1x, and again here if you will see y is equal to g2x. Or generally what you need to do, let's try to understand, the thing that you need to do is very simple. If you want to write here y by x, that is equal to g1 plus g2. Again I am writing in the second slide, then it will be very clear. If this is g1, this is g2, if this is y and this is x, then how can you solve this process? Y will be equals to g1x plus g2x, g1x plus g2x. So y, if you will take x as common here, then you will be getting g1 plus g2. So from here you can get y by x is equals to g1 plus g2. If how many transfer function is put in the parallel form, if you will say I have placed g1 here, I have placed g2 here, I have placed g3 here, I have placed g4 here, and here I am getting output here, and here this is our input x. Then what you need to do here, you have to do only, you have to sum all the process transfer function, that is equals to g1 plus g2 plus g3 plus g4. I think it's as simple as that. Only you need to add every process transfer function if they are placed in parallel. So here if it is a parallel, it is a parallel combination. Okay, I think it's clear to all of you now. Now next thing, it's very important now, and I am just calculating the reducing the transfer function. Basic things again will go to the tougher level. Understand? If this is, if this is our set point, if this is g1 and if there is a feedback, and if this is g2 and if there is a negative feedback, okay, if there is negative feedback, I think you can identify now which is positive feedback and which is negative feedback, if this is y and if this is x. Now understand one thing, how will you calculate? If this is y, this will be also y, this will be also y. Here this will go, feedback. So here what will come? Y into Z2. So here Y and this Z2 will come. So now here then this is a negative feedback. So you can understand X minus Y Z2. Here what will happen? This will be here, and this here will be equal to X minus Y Z2. And this here will enter into Z1, and after that it will give the output. So here what will happen? E into Z1 that is equals to Y. It's as simple as that. So you can write the value of E X minus Y Z2 that is equals to Y, and that is G1 is also placed here, so you can multiply with G1. So here you can write X G1 minus Y G1 G2 that is equals to Y. Now come here, just keep Y in one side and X in one side. So here you can write X G1 that is equals to Y 1 plus G1 G2. So our output is Y and input is X, that is equals to G1 upon 1 plus G1 G2. It's very simple, you can understand. Again I am going to discuss what you need to do. This is value of output Y. So there must be an output Y. So this Y is going to be feedback because it is our, you know, the measured value, output is going to be compared at checkpoint. So Y, and there is transfer function Z2. So here what will come? Y Z2. Y Z2 will get compared at checkpoint. This will generate an error E, and that error will be X minus Y Z2. And this error will enter into the Z1 transfer function, and after that this corrective action will be taken, and again this will give the output. So E Z1 is equals to Y. Here that will be equals to Z1, that will get multiply here, and after that this will come. Means here you can see G1 into E. So you can write Y minus X minus Y Z2 that is equals to Y. Again there is nothing, that is mathematical simplification. After that you have what? Y by X. So the transfer function that is equals to Z upon 1 plus G and G2. It's very simple as that. You can calculate very easily. Now I am going to tell you the short trick how we calculate these things. Now if there is transfer function in this form, if this is G1 if this is Z2, if this is Z3, and again it is going to feedback here, and if it is Z4, I am going to increase the level, now toughness level. Now if this is our output Y and this is our input X, so if this is a negative feedback control system, now how will we calculate this one? Now here this output is get compared to our set point. So this output will get out compared to our set point here. So here this will come as a Y, so here it will come as an error, and here this will come as a Y Z4. So here the error will be what? Error will be X minus Y Z4. I think you all have very clear to all of you. It's very clear to all of you now. Now if this error that has been generated here, that will enter into the G1, and this is in series. If you will see, this is in the series, and I told you in the series combination what you need to do, you have to multiply all the transfer function. So here what you need to do, here this error multiplied with what? G1, G2, G3, and that will give you your output. as simple as that.
Now, if you will substitute the value of x minus yz4 into z1, z2, z3, that is equals to 1. Now, multiply all. So, x, z1, z2, z3 minus y, z1, z2, z3, z4, that is equals to 1. It's as simple as that. You can understand very easily. Now, again, I am writing here. Now, just it's mathematical operation. Put y in one side and x in one side. From here, you will get x, z1, z2, z3, that is equals to y into 1 plus z1, z2, z3 and z4. Okay, y, z1, z2, z3 and z4. Now, our output is y and our input is x. So, our out, how can we calculate y by x? So, you will get in z1, z2, z3 upon 1 plus z1, z2, z3, z4. This is our desired transfer function for this closed loop system. For this negative feedback control system, this is our negative feedback control system. It's a very easy thing for my dear student. If you will practice more and more, then definitely, I am sure about that, you will be able to solve the question very easily. Okay. So, I have tried my best to calculate the error. It's very important thing. Now, again, I am going to discuss another configuration. Another one, so that you can understand it. If this is G1, this is G2, this is Z3, here there is also a feedback, this is minus, this is plus, and here there is also a feedback, and here if this is Z4 here, if this is the combination, now how will we solve this thing? Here if it is our output is x and input is x and our output is y, understand one thing, how will we solve? So if you will, you have to focus here first. This is your first working part. We will solve this one first and we will solve second one. This is a feedback, and in feedback what I have told you, if you will see here, just wait a minute now. Sorry for convenience. Now, what I am telling you, first what you need to do, you need to solve this particular process. So, here this will become equals to what? Z3 upon 1 plus Z3. So, this diagram will get reduced in the form of this one. So, this will become like that. This will be Z1. This will be Z2. And this will be Z3 upon 1 plus Z3. Now this will become in this form. There will be a feedback and this will be Z4 and this will be in this way. And this is our X input and this is our X Y output. Now already I told you how to do this solution of this particular problem.
just what you need to do. Again, I am going to tell you the short trick that you need to focus if our transfer function is in this form. A, if this is B, if this is C, this is our output. If there is a feedback here and this feedback is D and this is a comparator, then there must be a generation of error here. If this is X and if this is Y, then our Y upon X is equal to what? A B C upon 1 plus A B C D. 1 plus A B C D. It's a very simple thing, my dear. But now understand one thing. Again, I am going to discuss it in this in the next slide. Then it will be very easy to understand to all of you. Now, what I am discussing here, if this is our transfer function is A, understand here. If there is a transfer function A, there is another transfer function which is placed in series with A is B, and there is another transfer function which is placed in another B with C. Now, if there is a feedback D here, if there is a feedback, now how will you solve this one in the very short way? If this is our input X and if this is our output X, then what you need to do, Y upon X, that is equals to what you need to do, you have to multiply this one and this one. Means this is called as forward path. This is called as forward path. This is called as forward path. So you have to multiply the transfer function of the all forward path A B C upon there is a feedback. So multiply all the transfer function now. 1 plus A B C D. This will be the short trick. Means you need to apply here. This is the product of forward path transfer function. This is product of forward path transfer function upon 1 plus, here it is 1 plus. Now what you need to do here, you need to break the closed loop and just make it an open loop. Then what will happen, D will come in the series of A, B, C and D. Now here this will be the open loop transfer function. This is called as open loop transfer function. So this will be the open loop transfer function. It's very important, my dear student. Here is very, very, you need to very concerned. It is called open loop transfer function. And here it is called forward path transfer function. Sometimes in the test series or in the gate examination, you will see. Only they are asking about calculate the forward path transfer function, or if they are telling calculate the closed loop transfer function. So, my guess